Hey, Johan, are you alright?
Actually, no. There's a lot of things going on in this world. This society is troubled. It makes me mad. I'm just sick of all the routines and standards that people like my mom and dad feel like they have to live up to. On top of that, my father has done pretty horrible things, and I think it has a lot to do with how I am.
You know, you remind me of my friend Chris McCandless.
Who's Chris McCandless?
He was so fed up with the norms of society and his parents that he abandoned his life. He completely lived off the land and the barest essentials in hopes of creating a new identity. He ended up dying, but his story is pretty amazing.
A new identity? That sounds intriguing.
We could totally do it. You know, travel around the world with nothing but the clothes on our backs? What do you say?
Sounds a little bit difficult. What do we do?
It's easy. We'll walk in McCandless's footsteps. I know what to do.
Okay, let's do this. How to create a new identity the Chris McCandless way.
Step in creating a new identity is to cut off all ties with your parents. Here, listen to this letter Chris wrote to his sister. Once the time is right, with one abrupt, swift action, I'm going to completely knock them out of my life. I'm going to divorce them as my parents. I'll be through with them once and for all, forever.
Wow, sounds like he had a really rough relationship with his parents.
Yeah, he had a really tough childhood. His dad was abusive and had children with two women at the same time. It was pretty toxic.
That's really sad. Well, I think I'm ready to send my letter.
Great, let's do it.
Wait, so why am I donating all my money again?
So that you can start fresh. We're about to walk into the wild on an adventure, and we are going to make our own money.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna prove to the people that I don't need them to live. Let's just keep what we need and donate the rest.
I think you're getting the hang of this. Alright, so we should probably pack for our adventure now.
Right, so what do we need?
Well, according to Chris McCandless, we need rice, books, a camera, an old pair of boots, and just a few items of clothing.
That's it?
Yep, we don't need much. We need to get away from materialistic things by disposing of our money and other expectations of the world, we're going to just become closer to nature.
But what about basic supplies, like a survival guide or something?
Chris McCandless didn't have one. But then again, he's dead, so maybe we should bring one just in case.
Good idea. It's gonna be nice having a sense of purity and freedom for once in our lives.
I agree. Oh, where you been
hiding lately? So we're just gonna leave the car?
Yep, along with all of our belongings in it too.
Oh yeah, just like McCandless did in Arizona, except his car got ruined in a flash flood. He buried his license and burned all his money. Didn't he also do something else drastic?
Yeah, he changed his name. We need to do that too.
Our names? Why?
We're starting over, remember? This is the start of a new identity.
Well, how am I supposed to pick a new name?
Chris McCandless changed his name to Alexander Supertramp. Alexander Supertramp personifies Chris's sense of adventure and counterculture.
Kenneth Michael Morris.
What?
Call me Kenneth Michael Morris.
I like it. You can call me Beyonce. I think we're ready to head out on our adventure.
Great. How do I hitchhike if I don't like people?
It's easy. You just be like Alexander Supertramp.
Who?
Chris McCandless, remember?
Oh yeah, your crazy friend that went into the wild.
He wasn't crazy. He just wanted to pursue a life of adventure. Chris left due to other pressures in the terrible home he grew up in didn't set much of an example. Chris wanted to do something outrageous and felt going into the wild was the most appropriate thing to do.
So he wanted to escape a materialistic society and find freedom, right?
Exactly. And along the way, he met some great people and made trustworthy relationships with them.
And how do we do that?
Easy. Just be yourself. Or your new found self, Penis Michael Morris. If I love the sun, cause I wanna be yours, cause you wanna be mine, I don't wanna get lost in the dark of the night. This time I'm ready to run. Wherever you are is the place I belong. Cause I wanna be free, and I wanna be young. I'll never look back now, I'm ready to run. I'm ready to run. There's a future in my life I can't foresee. Unless, of course, I stay on course and keep you next to me. There will always be the kind that criticize, but I know, yes, I know we'll be alright. This time I'm ready to run.
Why are we here again?
To study edible plants, so we can survive in Alaska.
Just plants?
I mean, we'll do some hunting too, but mostly just plants.
Okay, let's do this.
Okay, are you ready?
I can't believe McCandless said this. I think I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. There's a river up ahead that we'll have to cross to get to our destination.
Wow, look at all this stuff. It must have been crisp.
Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A darkened plume to stay. Hope here needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
I'm getting kind of lonely out here. Listen to this paragraph I just read from a novel Chris left behind. And so it turned out that only a life similar to the life of those around us, merging with it without a ripple, is genuine life. And that an unshared happiness is not happiness. And this was most vexing of all.
Happiness is best shared with people. I miss my family.
Me too. I learned a lot about life out here, but most importantly, life is not life if it is lived alone.
Exactly. Just like Chris, who spent all this time in the wild searching for an answer, a new identity, but the truth has always been right in front of us.
We can't enjoy happiness alone. We need our family and friends. Materialistic things are just materialistic things. Find happiness in your struggles. Struggles are just a part of your journey.
Yeah, this must be what McCandless realized out here. We should probably head home so we don't end up like him.
There's a path just a few miles up where we can find finally cross the river.
With that fool found in your place.
This is my house. I hope you enjoyed our journey.
I learned so much about myself and life. Thank you.
Me too. I'll see you around, Kenneth.
Bye, Beyonce.
But can't you see your